Hi, I am Julian Bro. I am an economist and policy specialist. Today, I will be teaching you about economic fluctuations within a model of aggregate demand and supply. We will first explain what economic fluctuations are. We will then talk about the irregularity of economic fluctuations. We will finally touch upon the macroeconomic modeling of economic fluctuations. On average, the economy of the United States grew by 3% between 1961 and 2021. When we talk about the size of the economy, we usually mean gross domestic product, or the total price of all goods and services produced in a given economy in a given year. So, on average, each year, the total market value of goods and services was 3% higher than the year before. This is long-run economic growth. But this does not mean that each year the GDP growth was precisely 3%. Quite the opposite. On the figure here, you see the actual GDP growth in the US in this period for every year. For example, you see that the size of the economy in 2021 was 6% larger than in 2020. While in 2020, the total market value of goods and services produced was almost 3% less than in 2019. These deviations from the long-run growth are called economic fluctuations. So, to sum up, economic fluctuations are the deviation of the GDP from the long-run trend. The economy can grow faster than the trend. We will call it a period of expansion, or boom. The economy can also grow slower than the trend, or even decrease in size. We will call the situation when the growth rates of the economy are negative a recession, or bust. A prolonged and severe recession is called depression. The variations in booms and busts in the economy are referred to as business cycles. The first phase of a business cycle is an expansion, or boom. Then, the economy reaches its peak, followed by a contraction, and finally, a recession, or bust. Then, the cycle is repeated. Economic fluctuations are an important topic of economic research. Governments, central bankers and academic researchers aim to better understand how economic fluctuations work. This is because economic fluctuations increase the level of uncertainty that makes making decisions by firms and governments more complicated. It also influences the well-being of households, for example, through unemployment and mortgage rates. However, despite all this effort, we still cannot predict fluctuations too well. You might have heard in the news the discussion of whether or not we are entering in a recession. But in practice, we are never sure until the statistical agencies report data on GDP growth. Imagine that we are in a recession. GDP goes down. We would also be likely to see that investment spending goes down. The interest rates decline, and the unemployment increases. As you can see, economic fluctuations are not just about GDP. They introduce a structural change for the whole economy. How do economists model economic fluctuations? One approach is to analyze aggregate demand and aggregate supply in the economy. Let's talk about aggregate supply first. Here on the graph, the vertical axis represents the overall price level in the economy. On the horizontal axis, you can see the quantity of goods and services produced in the economy. The aggregate supply curve represents the amount of goods and services that producers are willing to produce at any given price level, which is the GDP. In the long run, the aggregate supply is just a vertical line, represented by LRAS. This is the potential level of output in the economy. if all prices and wages in the economy can be renegotiated, this is the output level that can be produced. In the short run, however, prices and wages are sticky. It takes time to renegotiate them, and agents take them as fixed. Hence, in the short run, the supply curve, represented by S or AS, is a familiar upward sloping curve. Aggregate demand is the curve on the graph that shows the quantity of goods and services that households, firms, the government, and customers abroad want to buy at each price level. Aggregate demand is downward sloping in the long and in the short run. Market equilibrium occurs when aggregate demand equals aggregate supply. This is how the equilibrium quantity of output and price level is decided. In this case, P0 is the equilibrium price level and Q0 is the equilibrium quantity. In the long run, the output will always return to the potential output level Q0. But in the short run, the output level can deviate from the optimum, generating economic fluctuations. You can see this by shifting the short-run aggregate supply or aggregate demand curves and observing how the equilibrium changes. For instance, the demand curve can shift upwards. The new price will be P1 and the new quantity Q1. In the long run, however, the output will always return to the potential output Q0. However, the price level can be different from P0. In this case, it has increased to P2. A common mistake learners make is to think that economic policy seeks to delete economic fluctuations altogether. In fact, economic fluctuations are driven by some natural factors, notably by innovation and business cycles. These cycles occur naturally and are hard or even impossible to avoid. Economic policy can thus only limit their amplitude and their negative effects. Time for a quick exercise. Now, when you have an understanding of how economic fluctuations work, let's discuss the following question. What are we likely to observe in the reports of the National Statistical Agency when news outlets report that the economy is in a period of expansionary growth? Will we see a decrease in unemployment, a decrease in investment expenditures, or a GDP increase? You can choose more than one option. Both answers 1 and 3 are correct. Expansive growth means GDP increase, which usually goes together with a decline in the unemployment rate. As for investment, since GDP and investment usually move together, we would expect investment spending to go up, not down. Let's recap. When economic growth departs from its long-run trend, we call it economic fluctuations. Economic fluctuations are unpredictable and costly for economic agents, like firms, households, and governments. Economic fluctuations are linked to economic indicators beyond GDP, such as unemployment and interest rates. Today, we discussed economic fluctuations, how we see them in the data, and how we can model them in the macroeconomic framework. Thanks for watching. Check out Chegg for more resources on macroeconomics.